So this is the first numerical on reaction and beams. To be very precise, the first numerical we have already discussed in the previous video. So here we'll be discussing, that was a very simple one. So you can see that this is a simply supported beam having a hinge support at one end and the roller support on the other end. Okay, so let us draw the reactions. So let us assume that this is a vertical reaction here. This is a hinge support, so it offers horizontal reaction as well. So let us denote it by Ra dash, and this is Rp. So this is a coplanar non-concurrent force system. So you have three equations of static equilibrium. If you write down the first one, sigma Fx is equal to zero. Sum of all forces in horizontal direction. There is no force in horizontal direction, so you have Ra dash is equal to zero. So this is your first part that you have solved. Now coming to the next one, sigma Fy is equal to zero. Sum of forces in vertical direction. So vertical direction, you have two upward acting forces and two downward acting forces. So you can also write this as sum of all upward acting forces is equal to sum of all downward acting forces. So sum of all upward acting forces is Ra plus Rb, and sum of all downward acting forces. Now this is a 50 Newton force. So this is 50. Now this is a uniformly distributed load of magnitude 20 Newton per meter, which has been extended over a distance of 8 meters. So the total load now becomes 20 into 8. This how we have calculated, this we have already discussed, uniformly distributed load. You know the magnitude intensity, or you know the intensity of the load, you know the distance over which it has been applied. So load intensity multiplied by distance gives you the total load. So this becomes equal to 160 plus 50. So you have 210 Newton. So this is the second equation. Now coming to the third equation, let us find out moment. So let us take moment about point A and equate it to zero. So we'll be calculating moment with respect to point A. Okay. So the first force that we encounter, these two forces will produce zero moment because they lie on the line of action of moment. Now 50 is at a distance of 2 meters. So this is 50 into 2. This is the moment produced by 50 Newton force. Now this is the force which first needs to be converted into total force. So total force is 20 into 8. So this is your total force. Now this has to be converted into moment. So to convert it into moment, what do we need to do is, if it is applied or if it is resolved, it is resolved at a distance of 4 meters from C, or you can say it is resolved at a distance of 4 meters from B. It is resolved at the exactly middle of the total span over which it was applied. So it is applied over a distance of 8 meters. So it is resolved somewhere in between, like here. So if it is resolved here, the magnitude is 20 into 8 total load. This distance is 4 meters, either from here 4 meters or here. Now the distances have to be measured with respect to point A. So it is 4 meters from C. So with respect to point A, it becomes 6 meters. So this is written as 4 plus 2. You can straight away write it as 6. This is the first problem. So I am writing it as 4 plus 2. Now this is acting downwards. With respect to point A, it will produce a clockwise moment. So this is positive. And this is minus. Rb is at a distance of 10 meters from A. So minus 10 Rb. Is equal to zero. So this becomes 100 plus, this is 160, 160 into 6 is 960, minus 10 Rb is equal to zero. So Rb is equal to, this is 960, 1060 divided by 10 is 106. So you have Ra is equal to 104. Now, These are first problems, so let us take moment about point B and verify. So if you take sum of all moments about point B, so this is 20 into 8. This is the total load. Now, when you have a uniformly distributed load, first it has to be converted into load, total load, and then you need to resolve it so as to find out the distance from your required reference. So this is 20 into 8. It is resolved at a distance of 4 meters from B. So this is into 4. Now the nature is, it is acting downwards with respect to point B, it will start producing an anti-clockwise moment. So this is minus. Now this is again the 50 Newton force is 50 into 8. Again, this is anti-clockwise in nature. And you have plus 10 Ra is equal to 0. Ra dash will not give any moment because it lies on the line of action. Okay, so this is 160 into 4 is 640. So this is minus 640 minus 400 plus 10 Ra is equal to 0. So if you solve this, you have Ra is equal to 104 and Rb is equal to 106. So these are the two solutions, two possible ways in which the solutions can be done. You need to understand that here it was 20 into 8 is total load, 4 is the distance at which it is resolved from the reference point. 4 is the distance at which it is resolved from the reference point. Here if you see, 20 into 8 is total load, okay, 20 into 8 is the total load, and 4 plus 2. From here, first you will move 2 meters, then you have 4 meters, the distance at which it has been resolved. So this distance, this is force, this is distance. So force into distance needs to be multiplied to be converted into moment. So this distance, you need to be very careful how to use it. Okay, so this is your first problem. Now let us come to the next one. This is your next problem. So here again, you can see that this is a overhanging beam which has 2 meters overhangs on both the sides, and it is applied by a uniformly distributed load of 10 Newton per meter over its entire length. So this is, let us say, RB, and you have RB dash here. Look, in most of the problems, or you can say 99.9% of the problems, there will not be any horizontal force, but you still need to mention it, as because it is a part of the support system. ठीक है, क्योंकि उसकी value हर बार zero आ रही है, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि आप उसे लिखना छोड़ दें. Now this is again a overhanging beam. This is a coplanar non-concurrent force system. So you have 3 equations of static equilibrium. So if you write down sigma fx is equal to 0, you can determine that Rb dash is equal to 0. If you write down sigma fy is equal to 0, sum of all upward acting forces, this is Rb plus Rc, is equal to sum of all downward acting forces. Total downward acting forces is 10 Newton per meter has been applied over a distance of 12 meters. The total span of application is 12 meters. So you have 10 into 12. This is 120 Newton. Now let us take moment about any support. So let us say that you are taking moment about point B and equating it to zero. So if you take moment about point B, then you get the total load is 10 into 12. Okay. Now it will be applied at a distance of 6 meters from A. From A at a distance of 6 meters, it will be applied. But you need to find out the distance from point B. So if it is 6 meters from A, then it is actually 4 meters from B. So this is 10 into 4. It is resolved somewhere here and it produces a clockwise moment. So this is positive. Then you have Rc. Rc is at a distance of 8 meters from बी, आरसी इज एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 8 मीटर्स. हमेशा टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द बीम नहीं लेंगे. यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट 10 × 12 इसलिए लिया क्योंकि 10 न्यूटन पर मीटर फोर्स 12 मीटर तक लगा था. 4 इसलिए लिया क्योंकि वो ए से 6 मीटर पे रिजॉल्व होगा, तो बी से तो 4 ही मीटर पे रिजॉल्व होगा. डिस्टेंसेस बी से कैलकुलेट करने हैं क्योंकि मोमेंट अबाउट बी ले रहे हैं. ठीक है, तो अगर आप इसको सॉल्व करोगे तो ये आर सी इज इक्वल टू, यू विल गेट 10 × 12 इज 120, 480. सो यू हैव 480/8, सो दिस इज 60 न्यूटन. सो यू हैव आर बी ऑल्सो इक्वल टू 60 न्यूटन. ओके, सो यू कैन, इफ यू टेक मोमेंट अबाउट लेट अस से सी एंड इक्वल टू 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 0, अगेन यू विल बी गेटिंग द सेम इक्वेशन. टोटल लोड इज 10 × 12. इट इज रिजॉल्व एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 6 मीटर्स फ्रॉम, लेट अस से दिस इज डी. इट इज रिजॉल्व एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 6 मीटर्स फ्रॉम डी, सो इट इज 4 मीटर्स फ्रॉम सी. सो इट इज इनटू 4. दिस इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, सो दिस इज माइनस. ओके, देन यू हैव माइनस, ओ सॉरी, प्लस 8 RB इज इक्वल टू 0. इफ यू सॉल्व अगेन यू विल गेट आर बी इज इक्वल टू 60 एंड आर ए इज इक्वल टू 60. इट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल दैट यू कुड हैव टेकन मोमेंट अबाउट पॉइंट ए. सो इफ यू टेक मोमेंट अबाउट पॉइंट ए द इक्वेशन गेट्स अ बिट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, बट देन ऑल्सो यू विल गेट द सोल्यूशन. सो इफ यू टेक मोमेंट अबाउट पॉइंट ए, सो यू हैव 10 × 12 × 6, बिकॉज फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए इट विल बी रिजॉल्व एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 6 मीटर्स. दिस इज क्लॉकवाइज इन नेचर. नाउ दिस इज आर बी. दिस आर बी डैश विल प्रोड्यूस नो मोमेंट बिकॉज इट लाइज ऑन द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन. आर बी इज माइनस 2 RB. अगेन वाई 2 RB? बिकॉज विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू दिस, दिस इज प्रोड्यूसिंग एन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज मोमेंट. आर सी विल ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस एन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज मोमेंट. सो दिस इज माइनस 2 R, sorry, not 2 RC. This will produce, RC is at a distance of 10 meters from A. So minus 10 RC is equal to 0. If you solve this again, you get RB is equal to 60 and RC is equal to 60. So you can take moment about any point. If you take moment about supports, unknowns are eliminated. If you take moment about any other point, you will get these two unknowns also. So solution becomes a bit complicated, but at the end of the day you will get the same answers only. Now for this next problem, this is an overhanging beam of 12 meters having a 2 meter overhang on one side, and for this hinge support you have these two reactions. For this roller support you have a single reaction. Now this is a coplanar non-concurrent force system. So if you write down sigma fx is equal to 0, you have ra dash is equal to 0. Now if you write down fy is equal to 0, the sum of all upward acting forces, so you have ra plus rb is equal to sum of all downward acting forces. So this is 30 × 6. And this is again 50. So this is plus 50, 180 plus 50. This is 230. Now let us take moment about point A. So if you take moment about point A and equate it to 0, that means you're taking moment with respect to point A. So what is the total load? So the total load is 30 × 6. Where it will be resolved? It will be resolved at a distance of 3 meters from A. It will resolve at a distance of 3 meters from A. So this is 30 × 6 × 3. This is clockwise in nature, so this is positive. Okay. Then RB. RB is at a distance of 10 meters, so this is minus 10 RB. And 50 is at a distance of 12 meters from A, so this is plus 50 into 12 is equal to 0. Why 50 into 12? 50 is at a distance of 12 meters from A, and this is clockwise in nature. So you have RB is equal to 13 into 180. 180 into 6 is 3 is 540. 540 plus 600. 540 plus 600 is 1040. So this is 104. So you have RA is equal to 126. So these are the two reactions. Now, if you would have taken moment about point B, so this equation would have remained the same. Now come to 50. This is 50 into 2. 50 is at a distance of 2 meters. With respect to point B, it will produce a clockwise moment. So this is positive. Now coming to this. This is 30 into 6 is the total load. It is resolved at a distance of 3 meters from A. It is resolved at a, let this point be D. So it is resolved at a distance of 3 meters from D. But you need to find out the distance from B. From B it will be 4 plus 3. So this is multiplied by 4 plus 3. And the nature with respect to point B is anticlockwise. So this is minus. And then you have again plus 10 RA is equal to 0, because RA is at a distance of 10 meters from B and it is producing a clockwise moment. So, okay, so this is 100 minus this is 180. 180 into 7 is 136. So this is minus 1360 plus 10 RA is equal to 0. So you have RA is equal to 126. So therefore you have RB is equal to 104. So you can solve and find out. So you can take moment about any point. These are initial questions. So I am taking about moment about all possible points. But in the examinations or to determine the solution, you need to take moment about only one point and calculate the answers. Now coming to the next one, this is a uniformly varying load which is applied over a distance of 6 meters. The maximum intensity lies at 60 newton per meter. So again, this is RA, this is RB, let this be RB dash. So this is a coplanar non-concurrent force system. So if you write down sigma fx is equal to 0, you have RB dash is equal to 0. If you write down sigma fy is equal to 0, sum of all upward acting forces, so this is RA plus RB is equal to sum of all downward acting forces. If you need to find out the downward acting forces, this is a only uniformly varying load. So the total load is the area under the curve. So this is half into 6 into 60. So this is 180, half into base into altitude, half into base into altitude. So this is 180. Now let us take moment about point A and equate it to 0. So if you take moment about point A, what is the total load? Half into 6 into 60 is your total load. It is resolved at a distance of 2L by 3 from the smaller end. It is resolved at a distance of 2L by 3 from the smaller end, or L by 3 from the larger end. So it is resolved at a distance of 2L by 3 from the smaller end. So L is 6. So 2L by 3 is how much? So this is 2 into 6 by 3. This is 4 meters. So it is resolved at a distance of 4 meters from A. So this is into 4. This will produce a clockwise moment. Minus 6 RB is equal to 0. So if you solve this, this is 3, 240 into 720. So you have RB is equal to 720 by 6. So this is 120 newton. You have RA is equal to 60 newton. Now, if you would have taken moment about point B, then if you would have taken moment about point B, the total load would have been the same, half into 6 into 60. Now, it is resolved at a distance of L by 3 from the larger end. At B, you have the larger end. So, this is L by 3. So, if this is L by 3, this is 2 meters. So, this is 2. It will be resolved somewhere here. So, it will produce an anti-clockwise moment. So, this is minus. Okay. And plus 6 RA is equal to 0 because RA is at a distance of 6 meters. So, if you solve this, you have RA is equal to 60 Newton. So, therefore, you have RB is equal to 120 Newton. Okay. This is an overhanging beam of 10 meters. So, again, if you write down sigma fx is equal to 0, you have RA dash is equal to 0. If you write down sigma fy is equal to 0, you have RA plus RB is equal to, this is half into 6 into 30 total load, and you have a uniformly distributed load of 20 into 2. So this becomes half, this is 130 Newton. Okay, let us take moment about point A and equate it to 0. To take moment about point A, for this uniformly varying load, you have half into 6 into 30 is the total load. This is resolved at a distance of 2L by 3 from here. It is resolved at a distance of 2L by 3 from here. So 2L by 3 from here is 4 meters, but you need to calculate the distance from point A. So from point A, it is 2 plus 4. Okay, then you have minus 8 RB, then this 20 into 2, this is 20 into 2 is the total load. It is resolved at a distance of 1 meters from B. It is resolved at a distance of 1 meters from B, but you need to calculate the distance from A. So from A, it is 8 plus 1. This is equal to 0. This is clockwise in nature, so this is positive. So if you resolve this, you have 540 minus 8 RB. This is 40 into 9 is 360. So this is plus 360 is equal to 0. So you have RB is equal to 360 and also 900 by 8. Now, if you would have taken moment about point B, and equated it to zero, then your equation would have been this uniformly distributed load. This is 20 into 2 into 1. This is resolved at a distance of 1 meters from B. This is clockwise in nature, so this is positive. This is half into 6 into 30. This is your total load. This is resolved at a distance of 2 meters from B. So this is multiplied by 2. It will be resolved somewhere here. So this is clockwise in, anti-clockwise in nature. So this is minus. This is a clockwise moment. So this is plus 8 RA is equal to 0. So again, if you solve this, you will get the same values of RA and RB. So you can write down the equations in any possible manner. Now coming to the next problem. Now this is the last type of load where it has been subjected to a constant moment. So this is a constant moment. Again, let us denote the reactions. This is RA. This is RA dash. This is RB. Okay. So again, if you write down sigma fx is equal to 0, so you have RA dash equal to 0. Now let us write down sigma fy is equal to 0. Now this is a force equation. So in this force equation, you have आर ए इज वन फोर्स, आर बी इज अनदर फोर्स, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 50 न्यूटन. दिस इज अ मोमेंट एंड दिस इज अ फोर्स इक्वेशन. सो मोमेंट विल नॉट बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द फोर्स इक्वेशन. वी ओनली नो द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द मोमेंट एंड द लोकेशन वेयर इट हैज बीन अप्लाइड. वी डू नॉट नो द फोर्स विच हैज लेड टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस मोमेंट. सो देयरफॉर if force is not known, this is a force equation, there will be no mention of force here, of moment in this equation. Now let us find out moment about point A and equate it to zero. If you write down moment about point A, these two will not produce any moment. This is a clockwise moment of magnitude 100 newton meter, so it will simply be written like this, 100. It is clockwise. This itself is a moment, so it won't be multiplied by any term. ठीक है, ये सीधे सीधे moment ही given है, तो आपको moment equation में moment forces को moment बनाना पड़ता था. यहाँ पे खुद ब खुद moment given है, तो आपको किसी को moment कुछ भी convert करने की जरूरत नहीं है. ठीक है, 50 न्यूटन फोर्स है, इसको आपको moment बनाना पड़ेगा. 50 न्यूटन फोर्स A से 6 मीटर की दूरी पे है और ये clockwise moment produce कर रहा है, so this is positive. Minus, this is 4 + 2 = 6 and 7. Minus 7 RB is equal to 0. So you can solve and find out the value of RB and RA. So these two you can solve and calculate. Now let us see that if you would have taken moment about point B equal to 0. So if you take moment about point B, you have 50 into 1. 50 is at a distance of 1 meter. This will produce an anti-clockwise moment. So this is negative. This is a clockwise moment as seen from B or A. Aisa nahi hai ki piche se dekhoge to clockwise anti-clockwise ho jayega. So ye clockwise hai. Sign convention ke anusar clockwise moment jo hai wo positive hai. So ye plus 100 hi rahega. Theek. RA jo hai 7 meter duri pe hai and it is producing an clockwise moment. So this is plus 7 RA equal to 0. Again, you can solve and find out the value of RA and RB. So, if you solve it by any of the possible methods, you will get the same answer. So, you need not worry. And this is a constant moment. This will be used only in moment equation. There will be no consideration of this moment in the force equation. First, if you take moment about any possible point, okay, then also this remains a constant moment. Now for simplicity, what we are doing, let this be point C. Let us take moment about point C and see. If you take moment about point C, you have RA at a distance of 2 meters. So this is 2RA. This is clockwise in nature. So this is positive. Now moment about point C here, you need not convert anything to force or moment. This is a constant moment about point C. पहले से moment है तो आपको इसको convert नहीं करना. जब convert नहीं करना तो perpendicular distance नहीं होगी. तो perpendicular distance नहीं होगी तो zero होने का सवाल नहीं उठता. तो moment about C में भी आपको यह moment दिखेगा. So this is 100. This will remain 100. This will remain positive. भले ही आप सी के अबाउट क्यों ना लें. 50 न्यूटन क्या है, 50 इंटू सी से दूरी है 4. इट विल प्रोड्यूस अ क्लॉकवाइज मोमेंट. सो दिस इज पॉजिटिव एंड आर बी इज माइनस 5 आर बी इक्वल टू 0. इफ यू सॉल्व दिस अगेन यू विल गेट द सेम मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ आर ए एंड आर बी. सो द आंसर विल नॉट वेरी इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ योर रेफरेंस ऑफ मोमेंट. Okay, so these are the 6 numericals.